see. You'll do the race. You know how difficult the race. There we go. Now they're starting to pull in. Still shouldn't have, you know, 1.2 seconds on E2.
Lewis Hamilton provided us with the performance of the day here in qualifying. Fastest lap means he's on the pole for tomorrow's race.
A bit closer than I thought it was turning out to be. We'll see. If it's if the race is just too easy, then maybe I'll up the difficulty a little bit. But I have not yet ever raced on this track, so I'm very unfamiliar with it. I expect I'll be making lots of mistakes.
Welcome. You join us here in Austin, Texas, for what is sure to be an exciting day's racing. The 2 o'clock start is drawing near, so let's head down to the grid for the US Grand Prix. As the engineers make their last inspections of the cars, let's take a look at today's grid order for the race.
What does this crackagey look like? Okay, it's a 14-lap race. I'll pit on lap 6 or 7. Okay. That looks good. It's good to me. Whoa, fuck that up. We'll be right back. fuck that up a bit. So much for keeping them guys out of my DRS range. I love those S's. They're really good when you get them right. As I'm learning this track, definitely gaining an appreciation for its rhythm. The track definitely has a great rhythm, especially these S's here. Fantastic. Even when you screw them up, it still feels pretty good. I think one of the weirdest things that I'm having to get used to, this is the first. One game that I've played since the Advocate or the they put 8-speed gearboxes in. It was really weird shifting like all the way up to 8-speed and back down again. do think I'm going to have to try this again on a little bit harder difficulty. And granted, I could make a mistake at any minute. You get passed. Especially if these guys get into that DRS zone. I've got no choice but to be passed. But even though I'm just really, whoa, just keeping pace. I just feel like I'm kind of walking away with it, even though I've got this guy right on my ass now, and in my DRS zone, and he's probably going to pass me as a result. Yeah, Rosberg is definitely going to get me DRS here. Hopefully I'll be within his DRS range too next time. Well, he does look like he's starting to pull away a little bit. Not cool, brah. And he is pulling away, isn't he? Well, he's pitting. Hey then. What happens when these pit the window sorts themselves out, or Nico comes out, if he comes out in front or behind. I guess I need to try to put in a couple of, or at least a really good lap here. Yeah, when I come out of the pits, Nico's definitely going to be ahead. This lap sucks. I still missed the fucking pit entrance. Damn it. There it is, Rosberg. Oh, he's just crossing the start finish now. Shit. Yep, there he goes. on, Nico. PRS, yes. We got the better line through there. The one that I took was pretty damn sloppy. Speaking of sloppy. Idea. Love tires. Damn it, out of the DRS zone. probably going to start penalizing me if I do that again. Not gonna be able to get it. I'm 13 and my fuel light hasn't started flashing yet, so not turning the mixture down. There it goes. I can make it one more lap at this setting. Oh. Gambling on it anyway. That's it. I'm running out of fuel. Oh no. Yeah, he was just unlapping himself. Woo! I was running out of fuel on that lap. Oh. Literally running out of gas across the start finish line. Oh well, P2. Made a mistake. Teammate capitalized. Can't blame him. He just walked away. Maybe that is the right difficulty setting. Came out on top today with Nico Rosberg bringing home. My teammate can pass me and just walk away. 25 points to his championship. And my chances of doing better or doing anything at all at a higher difficulty setting are ill. I couldn't catch him. Us couldn't catch him. one more race, and I think I'm going to take a break.